Good morning, students. You're welcome to class. Today we'll be looking at number base 2. We started this topic last week where we're able to convert base 10 numbers to other bases. So today we're going to continue, and today we'll be looking at how to convert from other bases to base 10. That's our major focus. But let's quickly look at the previous area we talked about, talking about the common number systems that we have. We have decimal, binary, octal, and hexadecimal. Don't forget the rule in the hexadecimal, which consists of 0 to 9 and A to F, and it's called base 16. Now, today we're converting from other bases, be any base, to base 10. So, to do this, there are a few steps to it. Number one, you determine the column value of each digit, that is placing a power on each digit given to you. The next step, you multiply the column value with a column digit, and then you sum the products together. So let's look at a few examples to put these steps into practice. And at this corner here, I have this to extend our work. Here it's talking about the power. When you have base 10, 10 raised to power 0 will give you 1. Remember, anything raised to power 0 will give you what? 1. And so on. Base 2 as well. So, we're going to put this in when solving this question. 1, 1, 0, 0. First thing, you place the power starting from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3. Then, the next thing, you multiply with the base, raised to power 3. Raised to power 1 times 2 raised to power 0. Then you have 1 times 2 raised to power 3 is what? 8. How do we get that? 2 times 2 times 2. 2 times 2, 4 times 2, which gives us 8. So we have 8 here plus 1 times 4 plus 0 times 2 plus 0 times 1. Then we have 8 plus 4 plus 0, 0 times 2, 0, plus 0 times 1, 0. Then our final answer here will be, so in base 10, remember to put the base. The second example here, we have 2C. Whenever you see C, then you should quickly know that it's in hexadecimal, where you have, you know, A to the 10, B 11, C here now will be 12. So when we are solving, we are going to replace this C with 12. So let's quickly do that. First, place the power here. We have those two digits. So we have 0, 1. And the next thing, 2 times 16 raised to power 1 plus what is C now, which is what? 12. So you put your 12 there. 12 times 16 raised to power 0. Then you have 2 times 16 plus 12 times 1. Remember, anything raised to power 0 will give you 1. 2 times 16, that's 32, plus 12 times 1, that's 12. And our final answer here is 44 in base 10. The last example here now is in a decimal figure, where we have 111.101 in base 2. We are changing to base 10 also. So in this, when you have a decimal number, you first place the power on the numbers before the decimal, following the same method, 0, 1, and 2. And after the decimal, you start from minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Now let's solve this. 1 times 2 raised to power 2 plus 1 times 2 raised to power 1 plus 1 times 2 raised to power 0 plus 1 times 2 raised to power minus 1 plus 0 times 2 raised to power minus 2 plus 1 times 2 raised to power minus 3. Then we have 1 times 4 plus 1 times 2 plus 1 times 1 plus 1 times, remember, A raised to power minus 1 will give you A 1 over A raised to power 1. So here we're going to have 1 over 2 raised to the power 1 plus 0 times 1 over 2 raised to the power 2 plus 1 times 1 over 2 raised to the power 3. Okay, let's quickly do this. 1 times 4 plus 1 times 2 plus 1 times 1 plus 1 times. Now this will give us 2 raised to the power 1 is what? 2. 1 over 2 is 0.5 plus 0 times 2. 1 over 4 will give you 0.25 plus 1 times 1 over 6 will give you, 1 over 8 will give you 0.125. Then you have 1 times 4 will give you 4 plus 2 plus 1 plus 0.15 times 1 plus 0.5. 0 times that will give you 0 and that will give you 0.125. And now we have our final answer to be 7.625 in base 10. So we're going to stop here. We'll continue from the Google class where we'll solve more problems. And if you have any question, kindly drop it there. Thank you. Have a lovely day.